Hey folks, Sirdar here. In this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we'll talk about how to set up Microsoft Windows Visual C++ without installing all of Visual Studio along with it. Microsoft Windows, by default, does not come with software development tools. They have to be installed separately. Many programs compiled to run on Windows are compiled using Microsoft Visual Studio. But Visual Studio is a big program, and not everyone wants to have the full-blown Visual Studio experience sitting on their system. So isn't there a simpler way? The short answer is yes. It's the Microsoft C++ Build Tools package. With it, you can install only the pieces you need to compile applications at the command line or through build tools used elsewhere. And the piece you need most is the Microsoft Visual C++ Compiler, or MSVC for short. So the example I'm going to use to demonstrate this uses the MSVC build tools to compile a C extension for Python from scratch. In most cases, if you use a third-party Python library that has a C extension, you'll receive a pre-compiled version of that extension when you install the library. But if you're writing your own extension or compiling somebody else's from source, you're going to need MSVC to do it. And the reason for this in the case of Python is that the Python runtime is itself compiled with MSVC on Windows. And so any components that are used with it also have to be compiled with MSVC. So let's start with a C extension that I wrote for a project that longtime followers of this channel are going to know about. It's my implementation of Conway's Game of Life, written in a mixture of Python and C. All of the really performance-intensive calculations are done in a C extension module. Now, if I want to recompile this code, and I make a change to it, I save it, and I try to do something with it, I'm going to get this error, which tells me to go to this URL to download the build tools. This is a stock error that you get if MSVC is not installed on a system and you're trying to compile something. So your first impulse may be to follow that link and download the software that's provided there and see what happens. Well, you're most of the way correct, but there are still a few things that you need to do. So the first step is, yes, we do want to visit the URL in question and download the build tools setup tool and run that. The build tools setup tool is actually the Microsoft Visual Studio installer utility. This is a tool that lets you install the whole gamut of Visual Studio components. But the secret is that we only need one specific one. So once the installer opens up, we're going to go to the Workloads tab and select Desktop Development with C++ as our workload. And then in the right-hand column here, you can leave either of these options as is, or you can just select the first two. MSVC and the Windows 11 SDK. Those are the most important ones that you need to have. The others are optional, but useful. Now note that you'll need to install the version of MSVC that is compatible with whatever it is you're trying to compile. In the case of the Python runtime, it is the most recent MSVC version that's listed here, and that's installed by default. But if you scroll down in this list, you're going to notice that you can get versions of the build tools for MSVC all the way back to Visual Studio 2015. Anything older than that is not supported and shouldn't be used if you can help it. But if you have a specific use case for using VS 2015 for a project, you can install it from here if you need it. But generally, the default version, the most recent version, is the right one. So you click install, and this may take a while, so go and make yourself some coffee. So I'm going to cut to now that everything has been finished. You can, in theory, start working with MSVC right away. Now, any open shell sessions that you have may not be able to use it properly, so you'll have to restart them. But it is never a bad idea to completely reboot after installing. So I'm going to cut to what happens afterwards. So I'm going to try to rerun my build operation on my C module now that I have everything set up. And as you can see, it now compiles properly, and it also runs properly. So to sum up everything here, if you need to have Microsoft's compiler tools available on your system in Windows, the most unobtrusive way to do that is by installing this standalone MSVC build tools package rather than all of Visual Studio. If you do want the full Visual Studio experience, you can always install that later through the same tool. But for the time being, if this is all you need, then this is all you need to do. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below and don't forget to subscribe and follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.